Hey traders, Jason here from Leavitt Brothers. In the last 2 days, money has rotated out of tech and into financials and other beaten down names, or at least it appears as if money is rotating like this. Tech has been the undisputed winner. Okay, big cap tech such as Apple, Microsoft, Amazon have done incredibly well, and smaller cap tech stocks such as Twilio, Datadog, Zoom, The Trade Desk, Square, and many others have done even better. Many have doubled and some have tripled off their lows. But they've taken hits the last 2 days. So how do you manage stocks that do incredibly well and then suddenly fall hard? The answer is you stick to what you're doing and you accept the limitations of your methods. Nobody can navigate the market perfectly. Nobody can get in at the low and out at the high. Okay, all trading styles have inherent strengths and weaknesses. If you're good at holding winners, you're probably good at holding losers a little too long too. And that's fine. If you want to nail big moves, you have to give positions time and space to play out, and that means giving some back when the stock turns. And if you're good at taking small losses, unfortunately, you're probably pretty good at taking small wins too. This is fine. You'll never have big losses, but you'll also never have big wins either. Okay? Nobody is great at taking small losses and hitting big wins at the same time. In theory, sure, but in practice, it's not that easy. Every single one of the tech stocks that moved big in the last 2 months had at least one and often two scary drops along the way. Anyone who stayed in during the scary drops and then bragged about their gains when the stocks continued up is going to give some profits back when the stocks actually drop, and they will eventually drop because nothing goes up forever. Okay, accept the limitations of your trading style. If you shoot for smaller wins and smaller losses, great. You'll trade more often, and you'll have a higher winning percentage, and that's just how you operate. Generally speaking, you chip away and you look for, and you're a singles hitter, and that's great. If you shoot for bigger wins, you'll trade less and have a lower winning percentage, and you'll give profits back when stocks go against you, but a big win here or there will make up the difference. You're not necessarily swinging for the fences, but you're swinging for doubles and triples, and understand strikeouts are part of the process. All methodologies have strengths and weaknesses. It's unavoidable. Okay. If you sat tight and nailed some big wins in tech the last 2 months, but are now pissed that stocks have fallen off their highs, oh well, it comes with the territory. If you want to hold longer and nail big moves, you're going to have to accept that you're going to give some back on the way down. You're not going to exit right at the top. And if you've been in and out actively the last 2 months and you're kind of pissed that you could have made more if you just held, hey, you're not sitting any losses right now from the last 2 days because you exited yesterday. Okay, accept the bad with the good. The good needs to be much better than the bad. Okay, but accept that all trading styles inherently have some bad. Trust your process and don't listen to people on Twitter that make it seem like they nail every move perfectly. See you next time.